Good morning. Can I get a good morning?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Just a minute. Yes, I don't know why so many unfamiliar names today. Gautam and Roshan, why are you here?
Ma'am, this is psychology. 10th class. 10th class.
10th.
Yes, I know them.
Gautam and Roshan, you may leave. This is psychology class for standard 11. Okay. So, how was yesterday? Which all subjects were taken?
Ma'am, yesterday we had English and psychology. I mean, for me at least.
Okay. So, English class was started? Portions were started?
No, ma'am.
No, okay. So, as of now, you guys didn't start to learn anything as such? Not yet. Okay. Which all subjects do you have today?
Physics and chemistry.
Louder.
Physics and chemistry.
Okay. Yes. Again, Ashna. Is she in 11th? No, right? Okay. Anyways. So, did you all research on psychology yesterday? Yes. Malavika is nodding. So, let's hear from her. What did you research and what did you get?
No, you told yesterday, so I was going through the first chapter and it was introduction to psychology and so much definitions.
Yes, and did you go through the chapter?
Yes, a little.
Yes, how did you find it? Is it interesting or?
Yeah, it is interesting because I'm interested in psychology. So, okay. But the first chapter is a bit dry.
Yes. It is very dry, not a bit dry, it is very dry. The first chapter is about the theoretical concepts, the branches of psychology, schools of psychology, then the institutional settings or the occupational settings where we work, the different fields in which we engage in our works, then the fields which are related to psychology, how can we link psychology with engineering. Can you imagine psychology and engineering? Can you find a link? Respond, people. Can you find a link? At least say yes or no. Psychology and engineering. Can you find a link?
I'm not sure how, but I think there is a link.
There is a link. Yeah, there is a link, and we are finding a link in the chapter. So, shall we just study one definition today? And then we'll do all the interaction thing again, because we have some more people to join our class. Since only one batch is present today, we'll start the formal classes from tomorrow onwards. Okay. So, we'll study one definition. Please take down the lecture notes. Okay, before we study the formal one, how many of you got the textbooks? How many of you have it with you? Shreya, Alina, Binav? That's all. Okay, if you want, I'll send you one PDF of this. Okay, can you send me a personal message? Okay. Yes. So what do you think? How do you think we can define psychology? What do you think it is? Share your viewpoints about psychology. Rose.
Ma'am, it's something related to mind and inner self.
Mind and ourself. Okay. Fine. Meryl.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
It's study of mind and behavior.
Mind, behavior, okay.
Feelings.
Feelings, yes. Devika?
Ma'am, the way we communicate, how patient we are, and...
Okay. Alina? Alina Varghese?
It's something related to emotions, behavior.
Emotions, behavior, yes. Malavika?
It's something related to the human mind and behavior and character.
Human mind, behavior, character. Then Abhinav.
It is the study of behavior.
Study of behavior.
Behaviors.
Behaviors, okay. Abdul.
Scientific study of human behavior.
Huh.
Character.
Scientific study of human behavior, character. Okay. Now, Emeline.
Psychology is a study of attitude and feelings.
Attitude, feelings. Yes. Shreya.
Understanding mind, behavior.
Understanding mind, behavior. Now, who did not get a chance? Anila, did you speak?
No.
No. Tell me.
Humans' behavior. Their
behavior. Only human behavior.
We can, in the case of their mind, we can relate.
Okay. We study about only human behavior in psychology. Okay. I'm not confusing you. Anyways, Eva.
Ma'am, I think it helps us find out why people do the things they do, why they think of certain things.
So basically, thoughts and actions.
Yeah.
Yes. Then, anybody else whom I left out? Alina Jason.
Ma'am, study of human mind and behavior.
Study of?
Human mind.
Human mind. Oh, right. I'll write a definition on the board. Just copy down and see how much close you were to the actual definition. Okay, so psychology. Yeah, starting. I know my handwriting is horrible, so please bear with me. If you don't understand, ask me every now and then, okay? Yes, psychology is defined as there is an important word here, not here. Formally defined as. What we did just now was an informal definition. What we gave was an informal definition. This is the formal definition of psychology. Psychology is formally defined as a science which studies mental processes experiences and behavior in different contexts. Psychology is defined as a science which studies mental processes, experiences, and behavior in different contexts. These are the three keywords in the definition: mental processes, that is one, experiences, that is two, behavior, that is three. All your thought processes, the decision-making process, the problem-solving process, everything comes under this, mental processes. Okay, then the experiences that you have in life, the lessons you learn in life, the values that you have in life, all those are life experiences. That comes under this. And the third one, as you all said, it's the actions or the behaviors. And that is the third one. There are three keywords in this definition. So in psychology, we deal with all these three things. It is a science that deals with all these three things in different contexts, which means in different situations. We are not confining psychology to our classroom settings, isn't it? We are learning about something outside our classroom setting, something at the workplace. It might be something at the school. It might be about people's behaviors and actions and the thought processes that are taking place when they are part of a family, when they are part of a society. Then it might be about the interpersonal relationship that you are having, everything. Okay, so it's about three main things: mental processes, experiences, and behaviors. And how many of you think that psychology is a science? Why do you think so?
Ma'am, I don't
tell me
know.
Because of the definition that I told just
no,
now.
No, I think in psychology it can be called a science because many of the things that we do in science, we also do in psychology, like experiments.
Yes.
Yeah, it's similar to science. That's why I would say
I'd call it science. If I tell you that psychology is a social science, would you agree with me?
Yeah, social science because it involves other people, society. Yeah, I guess so.
Okay, so you're telling psychology is a science as well as a social science.
If I'm saying it's a social science, then I don't need to say that it's science.
No, but social science subjects are different from the natural science subjects, right? Like physics, chemistry, biology.
Yeah.
It's a separate entity than our politics, economics, and all.
Yeah, okay. I would say it's both.
You would say it's both. Yeah. Okay. We'll see that in this chapter. How many of you agree with Eva? Devika, Abdul, Abhinav, Shreya. Your pen up or your hand up? Malavika, Alina. Do you guys have a pet name? Both Alinas? It's very difficult to call your full names.
My pet names are also same. Our pet names are also same.
Oh my god. What is your pet name?
Ammu.
Both are Ammus?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Fine. What to do? I have the same problem with your seniors also. There are two Amals in the class. And I'll have to call Amal Raj, Amal Kesaji, Amal Raj, Amal Kesaji. It's very difficult. Okay. Anyways, yeah. Back to our question. How many of you agree with Eva? How many of you think that psychology is both social science as well as natural science? I saw Shreya, Alina, V, and Abdul, Malavika raising the hand. Abhinav also, right? Rest of you, what do you think? Emilin, what is your opinion?
Ma'am, social science is completely about like economics, politics and all. So I didn't think that it is really, psychology is related with social science. I believe that it is related to science.
Natural science.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Who else didn't raise the hand? Rose.
Same as Emeline told, like something related to science. Scientific
method. Yes, yes. Okay. Meryl?
Ma'am, the same thing. It's completely different.
Copy paste. Okay, fine. We'll see that in the chapter because after the definition thing, we are learning about that. Psychology, about psychology. I'm not telling what. Okay, definition, is that clear? We'll do a post-mortem on that definition tomorrow because we are taking each and every word and then learning why is it there in the definition. We'll study that when your friends join. Okay. So we have so much of time left. What do you want to do? See, this privilege comes only on the earlier days of class. After this, you'll be running with assignments, PT1, PT2, then the term exams, blah, 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 everything. Tell me, what do you want to do? Yes, yesterday we did one activity and Alina left in between, no? So we'll make her do it. I saw her in the school. I was walking through the corridor. You came, no, yesterday? To collect the books. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Abhinav, tell her what was the activity that we did yesterday.
I forgot.
This was yesterday, right? Not 5 years before, 1 month before.
No, activity.
That's because you didn't do it properly.
Ah, yes, ma'am, yes.
Tube light.
Not you asked numbers.
To Alina, explain it to Alina.
She asked numbers and you think numbers. Only that much.
And was I teaching you numerics yesterday?
Yeah.
Then? Why did I ask you to think of numbers? Anybody who wants to help him?
Ma'am, what is unique in us that you'll remember even after 5 years?
Yes.
You're officially the tube light of the class. From today onwards, I pronounce you the tube light of the class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Easy to remember. I'll remember you after 5 years because of the tube light thing, isn't it? Yes. Okay. Where is Alina now? Yes. Alina, did you understand?
No, ma'am.
Very good. Devika, can you explain once more?
Ma'am asked what is unique in us that she will remember us even after 5 years.
I don't know.
You don't know. Tell me anything about you that I don't know.
Behavior. Behavior. I don't know.
Think. Okay, meanwhile, the others think of what we are going to do for the rest of the time. I'm not going to allow you to check Instagram posts, so don't tell me that. Tell me something else which I can do in the class.
Ma'am, a teacher's care and love towards a student and her behavior and towards students. Love and care. Like,
yeah, that I understood. But why are you telling me this? Is it because I should give you more love and care?
No.
Then?
No.
No, I didn't understand why you're telling me this.
No, ma'am, you are. That after 5 years, how will I remember again?
How will I remember you?
Yeah. No, the question was how you will remember us, right?
Yes, each one of you. Like just now I told, no, Abhinav, I will remember him because of his tube light behavior. Yes? Like that, what makes you special? Or tell me anything about you that will still remind me of you even after so many years. Think, you'll get something. Others, tell me what should we do now? We have to get along well with each other if we have to work as a team, no? So talk about something, at least any nonsense things.
Ma'am, it's not anything to talk about, but I had a doubt. I don't really have all the books because I'm not in India. And we decided to buy the textbooks when we reach India, but the notebooks, can you tell me which are notebooks we are using for this year?
Notebooks. Is there a list for notebooks? No, I don't think so.
No, I just need to clarify what type of notebooks so that like I can buy them from here and start using them.
You mean the ruled or unruled, those
types?
Yeah. Okay. Can you give me a personal message? I'll just inquire and tell you.
I'm
not aware of the type.
How do I contact you?
My number would be there in your group. I think.
Yeah, ma'am. How do I find you in the group?
That is another question. Do any of you have my number?
Me.
Okay. So, do you have her contact?
No.
Wonderful. We'll find out.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Any other doubts? Not like this. Something else? Thing. Alina, you want to ask something? No. Why is this Gautam still here? Gautam, my dear, are you Gautam or somebody else? Do we have a Gautam in our class? No, right?
No.
I don't have anybody in the list. Shall I remove? It's better, no?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. What do you think we are going to learn in this course? About what? You told me about behaviors, about thought processes, then somebody told about feelings and emotions. Other than that, what do you think we are going to learn? Any idea? Devasena, right from Bahubali, left. Okay. Then tell something. Right now, when you are sitting in the class and I'm speaking and you're hearing in this situation, in the current scenario, do you think psychology is involved? I can see Navarasas on your faces. You think psychology is involved? Speak up. Yes, Malavika says yes. How many of you agree with her? Anila, you don't agree?
Yes.
You agree. Rose. Also stuck. Shreya.
I think so.
You don't think so?
Yes.
You think so. All right. And Rose is stuck. Okay. And why do you all think psychology is involved? Malavika, you were the first one to
because
say.
It's because of your thought process that you are teaching us right now. You're talking to us.
Whose thought process? Mine.
Yeah.
So only I'm thinking here.
No, even we are thinking.
Okay. Just because of the thought process. Only that's part of psychology.
Right now, that's what I can think of.
Okay. Anything to add on? Behavior. What kind of behavior?
No response.
No response. Yes. So the moment I'm asking you something, you can hear a sound from my mouth, isn't it? Yes. So I am doing something. I am showing so many actions. You can see that also. So you can hear something. You can see something. That is sensation that we learn in psychology. Which are the five senses? The class is being recorded. Your biology teacher will see this. Answer carefully. Which are the five senses?
Smell.
Smell.
Then. Sight.
Smell, sight. Sound is not a sense.
Touch.
Touch.
Smell.
Huh? Smell, touch, sight. Hear. Yes, you can hear something. It's not sound, Abhinav, it's hearing. Okay.
I assume that you must see.
I know. Then.
Speak.
Huh? Okay, we'll change the question. Which are the five sense organs?
Taste.
Is it an organ?
Not my organ. Ear.
Ear.
Eye.
Eyes. Only one eye.
Eyes.
Are you an alien or what? Eyes. Yes.
That is.
Then.
No.
Nose.
Tongue.
Tongue. Then. The biggest organ, not the biggest, the biggest, yes, skin. So skin for touch, ears for hearing sensation. Then we have nose for the smell sensation, tongue for the taste sensation, and what else? Eyes for the vision or the sight. Yes. So sensation is something that we learn in psychology. It's a part of psychology. Okay, now you are sensing it and you are recognizing it as my voice. You can understand and comprehend whatever I'm telling you, isn't it? So that is perception, the way you interpret things. Perception, that is also a part of psychology. After sensation, we do perception. Okay, now I'm frequently asking you so many questions from the previous day onwards, isn't it? So I am thinking about a question. Creative thoughts. I'm making up questions, isn't it? It's not from a textbook. I'm making up questions on my own. So I'm thinking in diverse patterns. So creative thought process, that is a part of psychology. Then you are hearing and you're hearing the question and you're trying to answer that. So there is a problem in front of you. That is my question. And you have to solve that problem by answering it. That is problem solving. That is also a part of psychology. Then yesterday when I asked about the numbers, most of you remained silent. Remember? Yes. And you decided to mute yourself and sit there. Decision-making behavior. That also is a part of psychology. Okay. Then, what else is there? So, what I'm trying to say is, each and every point, there is a part of psychology involved. Even when you sit idle, even when you sleep, there is psychology involved. So, if anybody asks you that, tell them, there is psychology in each and every drop of life. Okay. It's there, here and there. It's just because you can't see it or you can't feel it doesn't mean it's not there. Fine? Yes. Okay. Now, you're not curious or you're not anxious about knowing anything more or asking anything more? Can I see a smile on your faces? Emily? Okay. Are you anxious? Are you very anxious now? Or are you relaxed?
Mama, I'm relaxed.
You're relaxed, okay. I have to get used to this now. That's why I'm asking. I'm worried if you're worried. That's the problem. Okay, then what else? If the other people would have joined, I would have started the class. But I'll have to explain the same thing again and again tomorrow, no? That's why I'm not starting today. Will you learn the definition and come for tomorrow?
Yes,
because
ma'am.
We have too much to learn. Too much portions are coming up. So if you learn day by day, then it's much easier for you. And for me too, to continue the portion, because all the portions are interlinked. So if you don't know the first portion, then it'll be difficult to understand the second portion. And this first chapter, I think first chapter plus some of the chapters that are coming up, it's a bit philosophical in nature. So you'll have to think more, think deep into what is happening. And for those who did not get the textbook, I'll just read out the chapter names. Okay, first one is about what is psychology. What psychology actually is, then the fields, the branches, all those stuff. Then second chapter is methods of inquiry in psychology. Methods of inquiry in psychology means it's more like the research side. How do we conduct experiments? What all are the types of experiments? How do you conduct a test? What are the important things required for a test? All those things. How do we conduct a scientific inquiry? It's useful for your project and case studies and all, for the experiments that we are going to do. We have practicals in 11th and 12th. Last time it was not compulsory because we had so many deleted portions. We had only 7 chapters last year, but this year we have to complete all the 9 chapters. Okay. And then the third chapter is basis of human behavior. The basis of human behavior, it'll have 2 bases, culture as well as biological basis. And in biology also, you have to learn about the parts of eye, ear and all those stuff. Last time it was deleted. Your seniors were lucky enough to escape that. I taught about the parts of eye, we got to know that it is a deleted portion and then we stopped there. So it was much easier for them and for me too. Then the fourth chapter is human development. In human development, we are learning about the different developmental stages, right from the birth to the old age. what developments and what development patterns occur in different stages of life, like childhood, adolescence, adulthood, old age, and so on. Then comes sensory, attentional, and perceptual processes. That's the fifth one. Sensation, perception, attention, everything. Sixth one is learning. Sixth chapter is learning. We are going to learn about learning. Okay. Seventh one is human memory. Human memory. Chapter 8, thinking. That was deleted last year, but this year we have it. Thinking. Chapter 8, thinking. Chapter 9 is motivation and emotion. Motivation and emotion. That's the last one. Only 9 chapters. Compared to the other subjects, we have less chapters. But the problem is, this is entirely new for you. You have no basis in this. So, it's like you're sitting in an LKG class of psychology. You'll have to learn from the ABCDs. Okay. So if you don't practice ABCDs, then you can't learn the entire sentence. No. That's the point I'm trying to make. So daily, I won't take much portion per day. It'll be small portion per day. But make sure you learn it daily, on a daily basis. At least before class, just read it for 5 minutes and come. So it'll be easier for you. Okay. Then what else? Any of you who would like to pursue psychology after 12th?
I'm actually interested in doing that. As of now, that's my plan.
Okay. Let's see what happens. Then one more thing. Whatever concept you have of psychology and this course right now, it might change in a good way. I hope it will be in a good way when we finish the course. Okay. And for some people, if you think psychology is very easy, it might turn out to be very difficult. You never know. Okay. So you put in your own efforts and I'll help you in whichever way I can. And we'll see what happens. Hope for the best. Yeah. So till what time is the class? Ten. Let me check. Yeah. Let me take the attendance. And attendance is very strict, so make sure you attend the class. And if you have any problem in attending, please let any of us know before. Unless there is an emergency case, okay? Anjana was absent yesterday also, no? Anjana, is she a new student or you know? Anjana.
Ma'am, full name.
I don't have the full name right now. Only Anjana.
Before class, there was an Anjana. Yes.
There was an Anjana, okay. Abdul is present, no? Yes, Shreya, Devika, Anila, Malavika, Meryl, Alina, Alina Square, Eva, yes, Abhinav, Emelin, Rose. Now, three people are left, Abhilash, Sandra, and Sanjana. Are they new students? Abhilash, Sandra, and Sanjana. Sanjana's full name I know, Sanjana Sunil Kumar. Are they new?
Yes.
No. Yes. Yes. Okay. Then, shall we wind up? Please be more energetic tomorrow because we are going to start the portion. Okay. See you then. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.